There's a number of other pieces I want to play, representing Jovino's music and the Ichibere's music. But I want to make sure that I cover his Som da Aura. And Som da Aura is essentially setting the spoken word as a piece of music. That's the spoken word. Every sound in the universe is music to Hermeto. There's no sound that does not have musical significance. A child laughing, somebody crying, the birds, bird songs, whatever it is. And so he started out, and there's a whole process which evolved as technology evolved, how they actually went into the studio and did this. Originally, he would just get somebody's spoken word on a cassette tape, and then he would go into the studio and he would record on the piano what he was hearing, like the melody, doubling it on the piano, and then on the harmonium, he would harmonize it. As things got more technology friendly, they took the spoken word and looped it on a sampler so that they could actually work with it. And Hermeto basically copped everything. Jovino, Hermeto wrote it out, and then Jovino played all the parts. That's the later ones. The first one is very, and I forget his name, but he's one of the most important soccer announcers from like that period. And you'll hear it's doodly-doodly, and it's the guy calling a soccer game. So usually the way it goes is you'll get the spoken word first with no music, then it's repeated with the music.
Ciscou pra lá, ciscou pra cá, enlouquece o seu povo, doutor! Ciscou pra lá, ciscou pra cá, enlouquece o seu povo, doutor! Ciscou pra lá, ciscou pra cá, enlouquece o seu povo, doutor! Ciscou pra lá, ciscou pra cá, enlouquece o seu povo, doutor!
And that's one of the more straightforward ones. The next one is pensamento positivo, or wishful thinking. And it is from a speech given by the then president of Brazil, whose name escapes me. I'm unfortunately unable to remember who the president was when this particular one was done. But it's really cool. And he's got a very deep voice. So Hermeto's playing it on a D7 clavinet.
Exatamente isso, minha gente. O pensamento negativo atrai pensamento negativo. Pensamento positivo é o que os ingleses chamam wishful thinking, né? Pensar positivo. Pensar positivo, querer pensar positivo, atrai bons fluidos. Eu sei exatamente os instrumentos de que nós precisamos dispor para atingir esse objetivo. E eu tenho, sobretudo, dentro de mim, uma fé enorme em Deus e um ideal. Eu tenho um ideal. Eu sou uma pessoa idealista. Exatamente isso, minha gente. O pensamento negativo atrai pensamento negativo. Pensamento positivo é o que os ingleses chamam wishful thinking, né? Pensar positivo. Pensar positivo, querer pensar positivo, atrai bons fluidos. Eu sei exatamente os instrumentos de que nós precisamos dispor para atingir esse objetivo. E eu tenho, sobretudo, dentro de mim, uma fé enorme em Deus e um ideal. Eu tenho um ideal. Eu sou uma pessoa idealista.
Yeah. So the next one is by Mario Lago, who is a renowned poet. I believe he finally passed away. He was quite old when he did this particular recording. Três coisas para mim. And he's saying that the three things in life that are among the most important are o passo, o gesto, o grito, which is like the step, the gesture, and the scream. And then he keeps on reversing. O gesto, o passo, o grito, o passo, o gesto. And the hysterical thing about this is that when he starts speaking more rhythmically as opposed to more rubato, immediately this is like a little bayan groove that goes, and then it just stops. And then at the end, this is the most hysterical thing, at the end, he does this slow rallentando as he's finishing up, you know, gesto, grito, passo, gesto, grito. And what they're doing is they're playing the bayan and they're doing the retard with him. And yeah, when you hear bayan, there's never a tempo change. It's just like burning groove until like 9 a.m. But the way they do it, it's just really hysterical. And harmonically, of course, it's really killing stuff.
Três coisas para mim no mundo valem bem mais do que o resto. Para defender qualquer delas, eu mostro o quanto que presto. É o gesto, é o grito, é o passo. É o grito, é o passo, é o gesto. O gesto é a voz do proibido, escrita sem deixar traço. Chama, ordena, empurra, assusta, vai longe com pouco espaço. É o passo, é o gesto, é o grito, é o gesto, é o grito, é o passo. O passo começa o voo que vai do chão para o infinito. Para mim, que é uma estrada aberta, quem prende o passo é o maldito. É o grito, é o passo, é o gesto, é o passo, é o gesto, é o grito. O grito explode o protesto se a boca já não dá espaço que guarde o que há para ser dito. É o grito, é o passo, é o gesto, é o gesto, é o grito, é o passo, é o passo, é o gesto, é o grito. Três coisas para mim no mundo valem bem mais do que o resto. Para defender qualquer delas eu mostro o quanto presto. É o gesto, é o grito, é o passo. É o grito, é o passo, é o gesto. O gesto é a voz do proibido, escrita sem deixar traço. Chama, ordena, empurra, assusta, vai longe com pouco espaço. É o passo, é o gesto, é o grito, é o gesto, é o grito, é o passo. O passo começa o voo que vai do chão pro infinito. Para mim, que é uma estrada aberta, quem prende o passo é o maldito. É o grito, é o passo, é o gesto, é o passo, é o gesto, é o grito. O grito explode o protesto se a boca já não dá espaço que guarde o que há pra ser dito. É o grito, é o passo, é o gesto, é o gesto, é o grito, é o passo, é o passo, é o gesto, é o grito.
The next one is Bird Calls, and these were bird calls recorded and then put on a sampler so that they could be looped. And so Hermeto, and they're little miniatures, he harmonizes them, and each one has a completely different musical character, and they're all just one in a row. So, this one is called Quando as aves se encontram, nasce o som, which is when the birds meet, sound is born. So here we go, here's the birds.
Thank you.
So, like I say, all sound is music. And everything is fair game. Before I play like the last one or two things, I just wanted to know if there are any questions any of you have. And by the way, if you have any questions about any of the music or the recordings or anything, you can always just email me and let me know where to get things and so forth and so on. There's a lot of stuff on the internet now, and there's lots of stuff on YouTube that you can check out with the group playing live. And this is an important point to make, that the band live was a very different experience than the recording. The recordings from when I was speaking to Jovino, and the thing that's really remarkable is that over all the recordings they did in the studio, Jovino never got one solo on the recording. And I asked him, well, why, you know? He said, well, you know, the important thing was showing the compositions. And at that point, you know, Carlinhos was such a strong soloist, saxophone, and Hermeto, and so he knew his role. But in live, they would have extended versions of these tunes, and everybody would get to solo, and it's, you know, he's just burning. So it really pays to listen to the recording and then go and try and catch a live version of it to see how it kind of transforms, because they get really loose. Marcio Bahia, man, what an amazing drummer. I mean, just loose and just completely just, I mean, incredible musician. And he has a whole statement about how he studied everybody's individual part and the relationship that his part had to it. And that was part of his preparation for feeling like he could really play the music. So for a drummer to take the kind of initiative that he took to learn everyone's part, and in addition to his own, is just another sign of just the dedication these guys had going for like 13 years, nonstop.